steel saw for everything just about. I'm going to cut the notches out that I've marked on there, the two slats. Skill saw. Like if you haven't used it a lot, I wouldn't use one like this then. I'd use a jigsaw, which I have one of those, but I'm not going to bother setting it up. So if you're not used to using a skill saw, don't do things like this. You'll hurt yourself. I don't have the guard on there. See, I got it up. And don't want you hurting yourself. Say I've been using a skill saw for a long time. Only hurt myself once on it. That was real early in the game when I learned. So now we're gonna put the little notches in it. First I'm gonna go up and check this. And I'm just cutting the notches so it'll bend. Check it. Alright, it's all notched up, ready to go. My hammer's up there. One side done. We don't want to forget about the lights. There's a light in the middle. It runs on AC and DC. And I'm going to run this across from one slat to the other, glue it, and pre-drill the hole here, and that'll be where the wires go through. Don't want to forget about the wires. So I'll put that on now. You see that little shiny thing sticking up there? That's a nail, but I was going to shoot a nail right next to it. I guess I hit it. Shoved it all the way up through. Can you believe that? How weird. Anyway, there I got the piece to be able to screw my light to. Now all I got to do is build up the area around the vent so that there's a crown in the roof for the water to run off. And you can see I got the plywood in the other side, the notched plywood. I got it here. So we're almost there. Just got to build that up And then I can go ahead, put the insulation on, back on, vapor barrier, and the metal skin, hopefully before it rains. All right, now you can see that I got those in place. I glued them and nailed them with the crappy nail gun. And using a couple of clamps here to hold the ends down just because they don't want to stay down as tight as I want them. So there's the crown for the whole trailer. That makes a crown in the center of the trailer so that water doesn't build up there. That's, they're not all built this way, but this one is. A lot of them are. Most of them are. So now I can put the insulation on, the vapor barrier and insulation, and I can put the skin back on the top. It's about time, eh? I don't know if I've got time to do all that today. Probably have to do that in the morning. That's okay, as long as I get it done before it rains. Not supposed to rain till tomorrow night. Well, just in time. So you can see clouds are coming in. I don't know when it's going to rain. Probably, my luck, weather will be wrong again, and it'll rain tonight. So I'm going to have to plan ahead for that, because I don't want all this new work ruined. But looks to me like it could rain this evening or tonight. So there it is. I'm going to do a little patching with plastic and tape to cover where this vapor barrier has torn away. So I'll do a little bit of work on that. I'll use plastic like this up here that you see in places. And what that's for is the metal will condense water on the inside. Warm on the inside, cold on the outside, water condenses on the metal. And then that drips on your paneling and ruins your paneling. So a lot of times, the paneling's not ruined because of rain. If you rebuilt your trailer and you didn't put a vapor barrier back in there, just the condensation's gonna leak through to your paneling and ruin it. So there you go. So, gotta pack her away for the night. Hope it doesn't rain tonight, because I want to get the lid on tomorrow. Boy, this camera just does not like reflect. You know, it's cloudy, and it still doesn't like the way the sun reflects into it. It's an old camera. It's an old Sony CyberShot, so it's time to replace it. All I need is money.